Live, local, breaking news. This is WYFF News 4 at 6 in high definition.
An upstate councilwoman is considering possible legal action against the county she represents in response to the revelation that one of her co-council members used to be a member of the KKK. Good evening. Welcome. I'm Michael Cogdill.
And I'm Carol Goldsmith. We begin with a story News 4 broke yesterday. Tonight, Anderson County Councilwoman Gracie Floyd says she's not surprised by court documents that revealed another councilman's affiliation with the Ku Klux Klan.
News 4's Mandy Gaither is live and local on the story from our Anderson newsroom tonight. Mandy, legal action against Anderson County could lie ahead here.
Well, that's right. Gracie Floyd told me she first wants to talk to the voters in her district before deciding what to do, but she says she has felt mistreated while serving on council and says that the revelation involving Councilman Eddie Moore's former involvement in the KKK is proof, she says, that she was targeted in more ways than one.
For the past several years, Anderson County Councilwoman Gracie Floyd says she's kept notes on what she calls harassment by other council members at their meetings. She says a lot of it came from Councilman Eddie Moore.
I have always felt a lot of pressure and, as I said, a lot of aggression coming from this particular council member to me.
Floyd says she now believes that aggression was not always about politics, but instead about the color of her skin. That belief was born out of this deposition that became public Monday, in which Moore admitted to being a member of the KKK in his early younger days, probably as a teenager.
Based on the way that this man treated me, I would say that that maybe he still has some of those tendencies.
Moore told News 4 he no longer has an affiliation with the KKK and says he went to meetings as a sheriff's deputy because he was encouraged to in order to keep an eye on people there. None of that explanation is written in that section of the deposition.
If he was that teenage boy that he said he was, then why, what deputy, I mean, what sheriff would ask a teenage boy to go undercover to do something like that?
Floyd says she's written letters complaining about her treatment by council members to the council chairperson before, but in light of the deposition, says she wants to talk to the voters in her district and explore all options, including possible legal action against the county.
I feel that I have a case for racial discrimination.
Now, I've left a message for Eddie Moore, but I haven't heard back from him just yet. Yesterday, Moore told me that what he's done on council for the last 4 years speaks very loudly about how he feels about African Americans, and he cited his recognition of prominent African Americans with local ties. Mandy Gaither, WYFF News 4, live in the Anderson newsroom.
Mandy, thank you. Now to Greenville County, where the sheriff's office has formally charged a man in connection with yesterday's deadly standoff and shooting in Greer. 30-year-old Shane Young is charged tonight with burglary, and we're told more charges are pending in all this. Deputies say he is the gunman who went to an ex-girlfriend's home on Skyland Drive Sunday night, threatening to kill her and himself. The SWAT team came in, eventually stormed the home. Deputies say Young fired on them, shooting two deputies. And authorities say one of the victims in all of this, Kenny Horton, died from a gunshot wound to the chest. The family tells us a little girl was shot in the knee, and she also had to have surgery on her face. One of the deputies shot is expected to be released today. The other, we're told, has been moved out of intensive care into a regular room at the hospital. Sources tell us the alleged gunman is in critical condition.
A former Spartanburg County teacher is headed to prison. 57-year-old Mark Anthony Souza pleaded guilty to possession of child pornography back in April. Souza was a math lab teacher at Woodruff Middle School before his arrest. In February, investigators seized more than 150,000 images of child pornography from his home. Evidence presented at the plea hearing showed Souza was a customer of a commercial child pornography operation under investigation by the Department of Homeland Security. Souza was sentenced to 40 months in prison. The former Anderson County councilman who pleaded guilty to mail fraud is expected to be sentenced next month. Ron Wilson pleaded guilty back in July in a multi-million dollar Ponzi scheme that involved buying silver. Authorities say hundreds of people invested about $90 million with Wilson. He is due in federal court in Greenville on November 13th to be sentenced. Wilson faces up to 20 years in prison. Last week, Wallace Lindsay Howell was charged with helping Wilson keep the scheme going.
A violent case of road rage ended with one man bleeding from the face, another in jail. News 4's Mike McCormick is live and local on this story. He is in our Spartan tonight. Mike, first of all, how's the victim doing?
Well, Michael, he's doing well. He says he was more concerned about his wife and children who were in the car with him.
You never know. You never know what's going to happen. It's dangerous these days.
Mark Gilbert learned that lesson firsthand Monday night.
Be prepared for anything.
He and his family were headed to dinner on Spartanburg's west side, but the van in front of them was going well under the speed limit because of the car in front of it.
And they would slam it on brakes three or four times trying to get the van to hit them.
Gilbert says he went around the two vehicles to get onto I-85, and that's when the Honda started giving him trouble.
The Honda followed us onto the interstate and come flying up on us and flashing lights and shooting birds.
He says the driver of the Honda then threw something into his car, hitting him in the face. You can still see the mark it made.
It was like a little battery pack remote control. It had two AA batteries in it.
Gilbert followed the car to get a license plate number.
He got out of the car with a ratchet, and I told him that the police was on their way. So he jumped back in the car.
Gilbert and his wife called 911. Deputies eventually arrested Walter Barnett and charged him with assault and battery third degree.
If we didn't report him, you know, the next time he might call somebody to really wreck and all of them get killed.
Tonight, Walter Barnett is out on bond. We did go by his house, but nobody answered the door. Mike McCormick, WYFF News 4, live tonight in the Spartanburg newsroom.
Mike, thank you. An uncle was arrested this evening in the death of his 7-month-old niece. 26-year-old Mackenzie Lee Turner is charged with murder and homicide by child abuse. He is being held in the Oconee County Jail. The little girl was from Fairplay. She died last night in the pediatric ICU at Greenville Memorial Hospital. The coroner tells us Amy Genesis Stashluk was at Turner's home on Hicks Lane in Seneca. We are told she stopped breathing. She was flown to Greenville early on Sunday morning.
A Tri-County Tech student died this afternoon while working on a school project. This happened on Linmar Circle in Anderson County. People at the scene say two men were working on that project, and investigators now tell us 23-year-old Jason Alexander Roberts was driving the car slowly while 23-year-old Joshua Dylan Addis was on the hood of the car shooting some video. Witnesses say the car came around a corner, the man fell off the hood and hit his head on the asphalt. The coroner says he died there where it happened. The Highway Patrol is still investigating this.
Fire crews responded to a used car lot this afternoon in Spartanburg County. Sky 4 flew over the scene. This is Pat Tinsley Used Cars. It's on Highway 9 and Business 85. Officials tell us the fire started at about 4 this afternoon. You can see some heavy damage to the building on the lot. We're still waiting for more details. And we'll keep you posted on air and online at WYFF4.com as more information becomes available.
In the 2012 for you tonight, Franklin Graham has said he will do all he can to get Mitt Romney elected president of the United States.
Now the BillyGraham.org website is making some changes when it comes to how it defines Mormonism. News 4's Nigel Robertson has the story.
Take a look. The Asheville Citizen-Times captured this screenshot of the BillyGraham.org website. The organization states a cult is any group which teaches doctrines or beliefs that deviate from the biblical message of the Christian faith. It went on to say some of those groups are Jehovah Witnesses, Mormons, the Unification Church, Unitarians, Spiritists, Scientologists, and others. This was on the site before Republican presidential candidate Mitt Romney stopped in Asheville last week, where he sat down for this photo op with the Reverend Billy Graham and Franklin Graham. But now it appears that webpage labeling Mormonism as a cult has now disappeared from the website. Furman political science professor Don Acey says in this election, it comes down to values, not doctrine.
I think that's it exactly. I think that not only the Billy Graham Association, but many, many Christians who favor, say, Romney, who is a Mormon, are much more interested in the issues involving morals, same-sex marriage, abortion.
Nigel Robertson, WYFF News 4.
The chief of staff for the Billy Graham Evangelistic Association sent us this statement, quote, "Our primary focus at the Billy Graham Evangelistic Association has always been promoting the gospel of Jesus Christ. We remove the information from the website because we do not wish to participate in a theological debate about something that has become politicized during this campaign," End quote.
This is expected to draw a crowd. Tonight, much of the country will watch President Barack Obama and Mitt Romney in their second presidential debate. That debate will air live tonight starting at 9 o'clock. You can see it live, of course, right here on WYFF4. And look for highlights on WYFF News 4 at 11 and on WYFF4.com.
A Greenville County teacher has a lesson for all of us.
As News 4's Gabrielle Komorowski reports, something she recently did may have saved her young student's life.
It scared the living death out of me.
Sixth grader Alex Smith was eating a hot dog during lunchtime at Tanglewood Middle School when something went wrong.
A little piece of bread was stuck right there, so I got my milk and I drunk some and I swallowed it, it wouldn't go down. So I drunk some more and I swallowed it, it wouldn't go down. And then I jumped up and ran over there to Miss Amadon and I was pointing at my throat.
I guess my mother instinct kicked in and I just kind of whipped him around, and I came around because he's on the other side of the table, and I started doing the Heimlich maneuver on him.
His math teacher, Amy Amadon, had learned the Heimlich maneuver back in college, but never actually performed it.
There was no option, so I just did it. I didn't want him to, you know, end up hurt from it.
Alex was okay.
This is what I told my friend once. I said, if you ever eat a hot dog or anything that you might think you choke on, always chew it up good.
There is now a special bond between these two.
Thank you, Miss Emma.
You're welcome, Alex.
And a lesson we could all learn about safety.
I'm just glad I had the training and that God gave me the ability to get it out at that moment and be there for him.
Gabrielle Komorowski, WYFF News 4, Greenville County.
Now your live Super Doppler 4 HD weather forecast.
And live Super Doppler 4 HD showing no rain across the area. And we're going to stay dry for quite a while, at least until we get into probably late Wednesday night, tomorrow night, Thursday morning in particular, a chance of some showers and thundershowers moving across the area. So far, official high today, 70 degrees at the JSP International Airport, 48 the low this morning, and pretty close to the average for this time of the year. At the Asheville Regional Airport, so far, high temperature 67, low 46, also pretty close to the average for this time of the year and far from the record highs or the record lows on this date. So mid to high level clouds moving across our skies pretty quickly in from the west. Downtown Greenville, currently 68 degrees, a very light south to southeasterly wind. Humidity right now at 40%. In Spartanburg, currently 64 degrees, humidity at 56%. Southeast wind very light at 5 miles per hour. In Anderson, currently 67 degrees, no wind over the last few minutes, and relative humidity at 42%. In Asheville, currently 62 degrees, humidity fairly low at 35%. A northwest breeze at 7 miles per hour. So temperatures pleasant outside. Cool spot, 55 degrees in Boone. Everybody's basically in the 60s, as you can see, across the entire area. And we're going to cool down, but it's going to be a very slow process tonight because of the mid to high level clouds that are moving across our skies and made up of ice crystals, and they're way up there, but still it's enough to cap the warm air that we had during the day today to be released into outer space and replaced by colder air. That's not going to be the case. So it's still going to be a chilly night tonight, but not as cold as if we had clear skies. 68 right now in Atlanta, 70 in Macon, at 71 degrees in Columbia, also in Florence, 70 in Myrtle Beach. So here comes the mid to high level clouds moving across our skies, and that's going to be, they're pretty thick. They're going to stay pretty thick as we go through most of the night tonight. Probably late tonight we'll see the clearing skies that are taking place back here in Arkansas and in Oklahoma. That'll take place during the day tomorrow. Showers and thundershowers moving through Houston, but they're moving into the Gulf of Mexico, and things are pretty quiet. So ahead of the second front, we're starting to warm up in the Plain States, and that's going to push in for us as we get into tomorrow. So high cloudiness and very cool tonight. Overnight low 48 degrees in the upstate, 39 in the mountains, mostly clear to partly cloudy skies. Maybe clearing skies maybe late tonight. Otherwise, mostly sunny skies tomorrow. Some high thin cirrus clouds probably in the morning. A little bit milder, high 74 in the upstate, 69 degrees in the mountains. So some pretty nice weather, at least for tomorrow. And then we're talking about on Thursday, scattered showers, possible thundershowers, especially as we get into to tomorrow, Thursday morning, best chance of showers and thundershowers. Dry Friday and into the upcoming weekend, and then low 70s on Monday and Tuesday of next week. So overall, a pretty nice looking forecast for this time of the year. We do need a little bit of rain. It could come in on Thursday morning.
Because this is generally a dry part of the year, right?
Usually September and October are usually our two driest months of the year.
Thanks, James. Yeah.